Now, Mr. Heiss.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. If we're going to talk hypocrisy, if we're going to talk that rules matter, then we need to look no further than what happened on the House floor last week when the House rules were outrightly violated and then the Democrats came up and changed the rules. So if we're going to talk about rules, okay, let's talk about them. The hypocrisy in here is pretty stunning. But the subpoenas here, look, we've already, this committee's already asked for financial records, already asked for business records. This is going far beyond the scope of official records. This is getting into nothing but an attempt to go after the family of the president in an attempt to further go after the president himself. And it's as obvious as it can be. And with that, the gentleman from Ohio, I'll yield to him.
I thank the gentleman for yielding. Just a couple points. The gentlelady from Florida talked about the Clinton example and this example. I didn't bring up Secretary Clinton. The chairman did. That's what I was responding to. He brought up Secretary Clinton in the issue when he was on the Benghazi committee. I served on that committee, too. So I didn't make that comparison. He did. I was just showing the big difference between the two. Second, the chairman. Hang on 1 second. Second point, the chairman just mentioned that the subpoenas to Mick Mulvaney, to the White House chief of staff. But I don't remember the chairman talking about Mick Mulvaney in his opening statement. He mentioned two names in the opening statement. He mentioned Jared Kushner and Ivanka Trump. So we all know what this is about. I didn't bring up the Clinton comparison. You all did. I'm just setting the record straight on the idea that she destroyed 30,000 emails.
Would the gentleman yield for a question?
Sure.
So what my friend raised as it relates to the Clinton emails and the 30,000 email reference that you made was a result of our chairman pointing out that you have inconsistently supported subpoenas of information depending on whose side of the aisle broke the rules, and that we had previous bipartisan support from Mr. Chaffetz, from previous chairman of this committee, no matter who broke the rules. And now,
reclaiming my time, that's why I pointed out, that's why I asked the question 10, 15 minutes ago to Mr. Raskin and the gentleman from Virginia, Mr. Conley. Did Ivanka Trump set up an exclusive private server, sent and received all her emails? You don't get to reclaim my time.
I'm not trying to reclaim it. I'm asking you to yield.
No, I'm not right now. She didn't do anything even remotely close to what she did. And when it was discovered that there were some emails that she hadn't properly preserved, what did she do? Preserved them. What did Secretary Clinton do? She destroyed them. That is a big difference. Their lawyer met with the committee. Their lawyer said they have complied with everything. Once she knew that, oh, by the way, there's a few emails I didn't comply with the record, she complied. Big difference from that behavior and behavior of Secretary Clinton. I yield back to the gentleman from Georgia.
And I would just add to that, and I thank the gentleman, that the content of these emails is not necessary to determine whether or not there was compliance
Great
to the
point.
Presidential Record Act. We don't need to get into the details of this other than for the purpose of going after the president's family, and that's totally inappropriate. I yield back.